Please subscribe our channel Education Point and press bell icon to get notification of new educational videos.
Hello everyone. You are all welcome to lecture number 81. And today I am going to discuss the stereochemistry of cyclohexane derivative. Really, the stereochemistry of organic compounds are very, very important from all point of view, even from biological as well as medicinal point of view. For example, it is the stereochemistry which tells which glucose is energy and which one is toxic, poison. For example, glucose is having same C6H12O6 formula, but the one which is responsible of rotating the plane polarized light to right direction is called dextrorotatory, and that dextrorotatory glucose is used as a source of energy, even it gives as intravenous injection to patients. And the other one, the same formula C6H12O6, is levorotatory glucose, means that one is capable of rotating the plane polarized light to left direction, and that levorotatory glucose is poison to us. And what happened, it is reported globally that once in some hospitals the glucose drip was given, and it was found that some of the children, they pass away, they died. And later on they check and they found that actually in that glucose drip there were levorotatory glucose C6H12O6. So this is the importance of stereochemistry. Only by checking the stereochemistry we will know the medicinal value and the biological activity. And also, for example, when we are taking tartaric acid, and tartaric acid is into two form, one is dextro, one is levo, but one bacteria, microorganism, that is penicillium, and that penicillium is responsible of assimilating all D form. So that is also used, that microorganism bacteria, just to get the L form from the racemic mixture. And let me tell you, to my knowledge, Borno State is the net exporter of gum arabic. I think the first number goes to Khartoum, that is in Sudan, and second comes to Maiduguri, Borno State. And they have three quality of this gum arabic, A, B and C. A is the best quality, B is second grade, and C1 is third grade. So first grade, second grade and third grade. And once what happened, somebody brought golden shining gum arabic, and he showed me. I said that it is a third grade. He said, but it is shining like a gold. I said, it is not on the basis of shining. The quality of gum arabic is determined by the specific rotation by polarimeter, which one is dextro, which one is levo, and on that specific rotation the quality is checked. Is stereochemistry is not the color and shining. And the one which was looking very dull, after checking with polarimeter, then I told you them that your this one which looks very dirty is of A grade, grade 1, that is your gum arabic. So this I have already told you that these are the most important uses of stereochemistry to determine the physical, chemical and even biological or medicinal properties, and especially in drug and pharmaceutical industries it is widely used. Now here I am discussing the stereochemistry of cyclohexane derivative. Previously I discussed the stereochemistry of cyclopentane derivative. Cyclopentane derivative is 5-membered ring, and here it is 6-membered ring. They are having a similar type of stereochemistry, but here there are axial and equatorial positions. In this cyclohexane, two positions are there. If the substituent methyl group is linked to vertical towards axis, it is called axial position. And once it is on equator, that is on plane, and it is called equatorial. So once it is the methyl group is attached to horizontal line, that is equatorial position, and once it is vertical towards axis is called axial. So axial and equatorial positions are there. It is very important to know which one will be more stable, the substituents with axial or with equatorial. You know, if the two groups, methyl group, if both are axial, means there will be crowding, and once there is crowding, it will be unstable. That's why the axial substituents of cyclohexane are unstable. And once they are equatorial, because there is no any crowding and there is no any angle strain, that's why the equatorial positions are always stable. And in most of the cases of cyclohexane derivative, what product we are getting, they are all equatorial position. So here I am showing here, it is your cyclohexane, and this cyclohexane is having the derivative. In one derivative here, both the methyl groups are equatorial, but in second one here, one is axial, one is equatorial. So this equatorial one will be most stable. Trans 1,2 dimethyl cyclohexane can exist into two conformations, one in which both methyl groups occupy equatorial positions and the other in which the two methyl groups occupy axial positions. The equatorial positions are less crowded than axial positions. Therefore, the conformation in which the methyl groups occupy equatorial position will be more stable as compared to axial one. In continuation, now I am giving here the planar representation of cyclohexane derivative, where two methyl groups are there, and here they are represented on one plane. It is in cis form, where two of the methyl groups are on the same side, and one is trans form, that is where two of the methyl groups are on opposite side. And let me tell you that this cyclohexane derivatives can be represented in multiple plane, like half twisted, full twisted, half boat, full boat, all those things. But here, in a simple way, I have given one representation, and where it is in the form of cis and trans conformation. And here, why I am calling cis and trans, because the free rotation is not there. That's why we can fix the position on same side or opposite side. So here, these are the two, where the two of the methyl groups are on the same side. That's why it is called cis isomer. And here, the two methyl groups are on the opposite side. That's why it is called trans isomer. The chair conformation of 1,2 dimethyl cyclohexane are multiplanar. They are after represented by simple planar formula. These planar representations are similar to those which are used in cyclopentane derivatives. Thank you very much.